wait away my yesterday, 'cause I'm leaving it behind me. Hello sunshine, come with me, I feel something new inside me.
Kayla, please stand for prayers. Prayer to Our Lady. We turn for you for protection, Holy Mother of God. Listen to our prayers and help us in our needs. Save us from every danger, and with your holy angels, defend us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Today is February 13, 2023.
This week, our scripture readings will focus on Jesus' ministry of healing. Jesus always showed compassion and mercy to those who suffered. People of faith came to him with their illnesses, afflictions, and disease in the hopes of being cured, like the leper and Peter's mother-in-law in today's reading.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus had come down from the mountain, great crowds followed him, and there was a leper who came to him and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, if you choose, you can make me clean." He stretched out his hand and touched him, saying, "I do choose to be made clean." Immediately, his leprosy was cleansed. When Jesus entered Peter's house, he saw his mother-in-law lying in bed with a fever. He touched her hand and the fever left her. She got up and began to serve him. That evening, they brought to him many who were possessed with demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word and cured all who were sick. This was to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities and bore our disease. The Gospel of the Lord.
Think about this silently in your heart. Pray about someone, some hurts, either physical or spiritual, that Jesus could heal today.
Let us pray to God for our needs and the needs of others, our family, neighborhood, and the world. For each need we say, Lord, hear our prayer. Today's birthday. It's Victor in 6B.
Sadly, over the weekend, our fourth grade boys basketball team lost their game. And don't forget that our furry friends need blankets, food, and more, and we are collecting those items until the 16th.
Mindful Monday. Losing is part of the game. If you never lose, you are never truly tested and never forced to grow.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic from which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. God bless America.
I'm Alon.
And I'm Kayla.
Have a great day.
Hi, I'm Anna.
And I'm Leah.
Please stand for prayers. The Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen. We turn to you for protection, Holy Mother of God. Listen to our prayers and help us in our needs. Save us from every danger, and with your holy angels, defend us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Many people during Jesus' time believed that those who were sick were possessed by demons. They did not have the medical knowledge that we have today diseases. Jesus treated the ill with love and compassion. Today is Valentine's Day and the feast of St. Cyril and Methodius, brothers who were Missourians to Russia. While evangelizing there, they tried to understand the people and their culture.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After they had gone away, a demonic who was mute was brought to him. And when the demon had been cast out, the one who had been mute spoke, and the crowds were amazed, and said, "Never has anything like this been in Israel." But the Pharisees said, by the ruler of the demons, he cast out the demons. Then Jesus went about all the cities and the villages, each teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to the disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into the harvest." The Gospel of the Lord.
Think about this silently in your heart. Reflect on the importance of loving and accepting people as they are. How is this important for healing or telling them about Jesus? Let us pray. God, we pray for rest when we are weary. May we care for others as you care for us. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We have three birthdays, Ryan and 2A, Rylan and 1B, and Andrew and PK. Happy birthday.
Our JV girls basketball team have a championship tonight at St. Thomas from 7 to 8. And our fourth grade boys basketball team have an All-Stars game tonight in Aston at 6. And just a reminder that our collection for pets is going till the 16th. Good luck, everyone, and happy Valentine's Day.
Today is Trivia Tuesday. Do you know what the two most popular Valentine's Day candies are? Chocolates and conversation hearts. Happy Valentine's Day. We love you, OLA.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic of which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. God bless America.
I'm Anna.
And I'm Leah.
Have a great day.
Wake up, OLA. I'm Delaney.
I'm Samantha.
Today is Wednesday, February 15th,
2023. Please stand for prayer. We turn for you protection, Holy Mother of God. Listen to our prayers and help us in our need. Save us from every danger, and with your holy angels, defend us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Pharisees were some of the religious leaders in Jesus' day. They were often obsessed with the law and rules of their faith. The challenges Jesus when they thought that he had broken the law. In today's gospel, Jesus preached and healed on the Sabbath. And today, the law prescribed the faithful to rest. He believed that loving and taking care of people was more important.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the Pharisees, "I tell you something greater than the temples is here. But if you had known what this means, I desire mercy and not sacrifice, you would not have condemned or guiltless." He left that place and entered their synagogue. A man was there with a withered hand, and the Pharisees asked him, "Is it lawful to cure on the Sabbath?" So that they might accuse Jesus. He said to them, "Suppose one of you has only one sheep, and it falls into a pit on the Sabbath. Will you not lay hold of it and lift it out? How much more valuable is a human being than a sheep? So it is lawful to do good on the Sabbath." Then he said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and it was restored, as sound as the other. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Think about this silently in your heart. Why is doing something out of the love more important than following any law?
Today we have two birthdays, Annalisa in fifth grade and Ryan in 1A. Happy birthday.
Sadly, last night our JV girls and our fourth grade basketball boys team lost their games, but the Mike Shaw tournament starts tomorrow, so good luck. And just remember that our furry friends need blankets, food, and more, and we are collecting those items till the 16th, which is tomorrow, so remember to help out our little friends.
We have some special guests today.
I'm Alice.
And I'm Audrey.
Today's weather is partly cloudy with a high of 64 degrees.
There will be some breezy conditions expected at 1 p.m.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. God bless
you. I'm Delaney.
And I'm Samantha.
Have a good day.
Wake up, OLA. I'm Lindsay.
I'm Eliza.
And today is Thursday, February 16th, 2023. Please stand for prayers. Prayer to Our Lady. We turn to you for protection, Holy Mother of God. Listen to our prayers and help us in our needs. Save us from every danger, and with your holy angels, defend us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Even though Jesus healed and cured most of the faithful who visited him, sometimes Jesus needed time alone to heal as well. Jesus felt others' pain and suffering as if they were his own. When John the Baptist died, Jesus needed time to heal. Even so, he was able to find compassion to heal others in the midst of his own healing.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. King Herod sent and had John the Baptist beheaded in the prison. His disciples came and took the body and buried it. Then they went and told Jesus. Now when Jesus heard that this, he withdrew from there in a boat and deserted himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the town. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd and had compassion for them and cured their sick. When they had crossed over, they came to land at Gennesaret. After the people of that place recognized him, they sent word throughout the region and brought all who were sick to him and begged him that they might touch even the fringe of his cloak. And all who touched it were healed. Word of the Lord.
Think about this silently in your heart. When someone is hurting or upset, how can you show them love?
Let us pray to God for our needs and the needs of others, our family, neighborhood, and the world. For each need, we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
We have some birthdays today. Sophia in fifth grade, Haley in sixth grade, Penelope in 2B, Alexander and Mrs. Cochran. Happy birthday.
Just a shout out to all of OLA. We thank you for participating in the Collection for Pets, and our furry friends will love it. And starting tonight and throughout the weekend, our Mike Shaw tournament begins, so come and support our OLA teams. First, our varsity girls basketball team have a game Friday at 6:45 in the OLA gym, and also a game on Saturday. And our varsity boys A basketball team have a game on Saturday here as well. And our JV boys red team have a game Saturday at OLA, and so do our JV boys white basketball team on Sunday. And our varsity boys B basketball team have a game at 7:45 tonight in the OLA gym. And tonight as well, our fourth grade boys basketball team have a game. It's an all-star game tonight at 6 in Aston. So good luck, everyone.
Today is Flashback Thursday. Who is this?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
God bless you.
I'm Lindsay.
I'm Eliza.
Have a great day.